Hi everybody, welcome to BrickVault, it's Mike here and welcome to our top 10 mocks video, a video where we show our favorite creations that we found over the course of the last week on the internet. Me and Jack are switching between weeks to take different looks on those mocks. Today I have a pretty solid selection for you, I hope you're gonna like them. And always, always, always at the end of the episode we are showing your fan creations that you guys are sending to our BrickVault fan mocks email. If you wanna send more pictures, if you're building something really cool, check out the description below, it's all the rules and the email is there, so make sure to follow them, it just makes our lives a bit easier. And before we jump into this week's top 10 mock collection, a quick update on our web store at www.brickvault.toys, where you can find really awesome mocks. We keep adding them as we go. Right now we are working on the Sandcrawler, it's a minifig scale beautiful build. Instructions are available right now on the web store. And also we have just added the newest Thai Advanced from Jarek, a designer you all love for his amazing models, and this one is no different. Great design, and check out the Jack's video on this one, and I really love it. Check it out if you want to purchase. Every single purchase does support our channel and every designer that stands behind those mocks. And of course, every single link for those creations can be found below. Check out the galleries of those amazing designers, leave a comment, follow them. I think they would really appreciate it. And also, my selection of top 10 mocks is a subjective one, so if you like one better than the other, don't really mind the placing or the ranking. It's not really that certain or important. I think many people like different mocks, and that doesn't mean that number 1 is better than number 10, for example. Alright, let's get into it. And starting off with number 10, we've got the Legend of Anandra. The build comes from Malin Killinger, and I'm not very familiar with this designer. I think the account is fairly new, about 6 months of uploading, but this build definitely caught my attention. What we have here is an open book with some beautiful foliage build. I think there's a treasure and some sort of a tree, an elven princess or warrior fighting what seems to be a bluish water creature, water serpent, or even a dragon. Definitely the dragon in this build, this head is a standout, beautiful build. I love the lime green and the dark blue color combination. Nice use of pieces for things that come out of his head in sort of a thunders or any powers just emerging from the head. And quite specifically the quote on the left side of the book, the beautiful golden ornaments, says every legend has a beginning. And I do like that E written in this rustic epic way. Coming up to number 9, we got UC Koskinen with his International Space Station, and I've seen many builds of this thing, basically a massive chunk of metal that is free-falling constantly on our Earth orbit. Many of them are good, but this one stands out in what scale this is built. I would consider that to be a micro scale, but the level of detail is quite astonishing. I think he was thinking for every single part that was used in this mock, and every single part seems to be fitting perfectly. I am not only talking about the solar panels, but also the connection ports between the tubes that make up the station. And also even the smaller things like airlocks or docks where the shuttles used to dock. And now I think the station is mostly receiving the Dragon spaceships launched by SpaceX. Great little build, and talking about SpaceX, this builder also has a small model for a Tesla Model X. So I think that the things that Elon Musk does are somewhat interconnecting in Juicy's builds. Alright, moving up to number 8, we have Cesar Soares and his Greenfish Inn. A very cute compact build of what seems to be a small medieval building on a shoreline or maybe even a swamp. There is a fish sign on the side, so that might be a fish shop or just a fisherman's home. And it does feel very realistic even though it's built from bricks. I do like the foliage and the way the building starts from the ground and connects with the swampy land. The tiny entry door is very cute, you have also two staircases. And the top looks like this Bavarian, maybe German style of architecture, with a very nice styling for the roof and just a nice touch of the chimney and the smoke coming out of it. So many small details, and I always appreciate such builds, this one just hits the correct notes for me. That is a really nice one, but when we move to number 7, this one is a bit more simple in form. That is W.R. Tyler with his National Gallery of Art West building, and this is part of the National Mall in Washington DC. The atmosphere here is very similar to what we would get from an architecture Lego set, but the lighting adds a whole lot of depth. Beautiful roof with transparent bricks, and also the front that provides some light shining through. We have a pretty nice recreation of the garden grounds around the building, and overall the scale is very pleasing, as it is with the architecture sets. That is a very nice creation. I would not say simple because I know this thing might have taken a lot of time to create, but I really appreciate the overall aesthetics and the cleanliness of this beautiful build. But let's go back to the medieval age for a second with number 6. This is the comeback of Mark of Falworth, one of the great designers that really takes on the classic themes a lot. And here we have his take on the original Black Falcon's Fortress set from LEGO from the classic castle theme, but this time around it is ultimately upgraded. The castle itself looks very realistic with impressive towers on both sides. There is the main gate, some foliage on the outside, and I like the fact that he created this one in sort of modules, as we have the main gate, a part of the defensive wall perimeter, and also a side gate with a small building. Overall, I do like this style. It's not very overbuilt, but it's just the perfect amount of details that we need for a beautiful display set. And I really do like those small snow patches on the ground inside the castle. It does close off to create a small square fortress, but I think I like it even more when it's opened up to see all the small tiny details. Pretty amazing stuff from Mark, and I really hope to see more from this builder in the future. This next one here with number 5 is Simon Przepiorka. I think that is a Polish designer given the surname, because I can read that. And I'm surprised to say that I did not see this builder before, and he's really into some nice little car designs. Most of his builds are Speed Champions scale, if I may, and the latest one is the legendary Lamborghini Countach. And what an achievement that is to create this epic 80s car with those crazy angles in such small scale. I am very impressed by the use of bricks here and the low profile of the car, which used to be somewhat of a cosmic sci-fi looking the whole 80s era, and even nowadays. The level of photography is also very high, but the build simply screams excellence and may be one of the best small scale car designs I have ever seen. A wonderful car to have in our collection, and let's move to number 4. And this build is not maybe very impressive visually, but the sheer scale of it is quite overwhelming. This one comes from Lasse Vestergård, and what we see here is the LEGO Amager Resource Center. Now, I thought this was some sort of a sci-fi building at first glance, but apparently that is an actual building that is located near the Copenhagen in Denmark. Also known as ARK, Copenhill, or Amagen Bakke, this is a massive incinerator building that was transformed to have a massive ski slope coming from the top to the very bottom. This model is built in scale 1 to 200. This is a really insane creation, and it's so good, it's actually right now as we speak exhibited in the LEGO house in Billund, Denmark. I am not sure how many of those grey pieces are used here, probably hundreds or thousands, but you have to admit the scale and the idea behind this is quite insane. Alright, and now let's move on to number 3, and here is the mech of the week. The amazing, the one and only, the super talented Moko came up with this thing that is called the Jupiterian. And that is quite possibly the most insane use of piece I have seen in the recent months or years. Yes, that is all LEGO. The weird thing that this creature has for a head is coming from a Bionicle set, the Kara part, that is set 8918. Many would say that this build is creepy. For me, it's creepy and beautiful at the same time. Looks very otherworldly, very alien, menacing, if I may. Well, you wouldn't want to meet this thing in a dark alley, and quite possibly it could fit as a creature unit for Zerg in StarCraft. I would call it a mech because it looks mechanical, and Moko is known for making mechs, so let's say it's a mechanical creature of alien origin. Pretty insane, and I just love his designs. Every single one of them is inspirational and crazy good. So if you haven't already, check out Moko and the other designers on the Flickr pages right below in the description. And don't forget to, of course, leave a comment and follow. Moving up to number 2, there is something I did really enjoy once I saw it for the first time. And you guys know how much we love AT-ATs in this office. We got like 3, 6, 10 of them, I don't even know. But I've never seen anything like this. Well, we've seen abandoned AT-ATs in Jakku, even Ray was living in one. But I haven't seen anything like that one, like an abandoned one that's actually standing. Great rusty effect on the entire body. I especially like the missing left front leg and some chains showing the previous connection point of the knee. Some overgrowth of the vegetation on the legs. The base plate shows some sort of a distant black planet. Possibly one of those Imperial factory planets maybe. And this thing looks excellent, not only as an AT-AT perfectly shaped to be honest, but mostly as a very creative approach to this classic walker. That is a great take on the Imperial War Machine by Andreas Lenander, and I believe we do not feature this builder as much, but I think we should more. Be sure to check out his Flickr page for some very artistic designs. And the number 1 spot this week goes to Berthil van Beek, a designer that we do feature when he comes with a new build, because every single one of them is absolutely insane. GBC stands for Great Ball Contraption, and this time I think he took it to a level above. There is a great ball contraption in form of a ball counter. Yes, it is a mechanical counter of all the balls that move across it, and it's pretty darn accurate. If you wanna see it fully in action, I'm gonna leave a link to the video right below. Check out the designer's video on YouTube. I do have a thing for LEGO ball contraptions. Those are some real marvels in LEGO Technic Engineering. And builds from Berthil as well as Akiyuki are one of the most epic ones, and this one is no different. Alright, and that was it for this week's top 10 mocs. Let me guys know what you think in the comment section below. Again, the ranking is very subjective, so you may agree to disagree on which one is the best. I think every single one of them deserves a good spot on the list, but all in all are all pretty amazing. And here are your fan mocs creations. You guys send amazing things, many of them are really really good. If you're working on something really cool, feel free to send pictures, the rules are right below in the description of this video, as well as the email to send them to. Alright, that was it. Thanks so much. Thank you for watching. If you enjoyed this video, you can always leave a like and subscribe to our channel. It was Mike, and we'll see you next time on BrickVault.